In this video, I will show you how to solve for the missing isotope. Let's use this constructed response question from the August 2010 Chemistry Regents exam. When referring to the answer booklet, you will see the following incomplete equation. Your job is to complete it by writing a notation for the missing nuclide or isotope. In order to do this, you should know that the numbers on the top are called mass numbers, representing the mass, and the numbers on the bottom are called atomic numbers, representing the charge. This is important because the mass before must equal the mass after, which means that 4 plus 206 must equal 210 on the other side or before the arrow. Likewise, the charge before must equal the charge after, so that 2 plus 82 must equal 84 before the arrow. Finally, to find the missing symbol, simply look up atomic number 84 in the periodic table and you will find your answer. Now, the chemistry regents has a tendency to use the same questions over and over again, sometimes word for word, and oftentimes right around the same question numbers, like this one from the June 2011 chemistry regents exam. Considering they use the same exact example, can you guess what the answer will be? And that's because the mass before must equal the mass after, and the charge before must equal the charge after, with 82 being the atomic number for Pb, which is lead. But even if they decide to change the letters and numbers around on you, like they did here with another question numbered 84 from the January 2012 Chemistry Regents, the rules for mass and charge still apply. So 60 before needs to equal 60 after, and 27 equals minus 1 plus 28, and not 26 like most students tend to think. As for the symbol, 28 is the atomic number for nickel, which completes the notation for the missing product. Please take a moment to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And if you are interested in seeing more patterns, tips, and tricks regarding the chemistry regents, make sure to watch 100 Ways to Pass the Chemistry Regents. Thank you for watching.